What's up, everyone? Lion Roar here, and today I'm going to tell you why this defense is killing it in the tournament. But first, join me over in Gemstone Legends. Most of the OG players who got in early on Empires and Puzzles are already over here, because we know it's players who get in early on games like this who are at the biggest advantage. Not only will you help support the channel by using the link in the description of this video, but if you use the code #lion_2021, you will get a free epic hero named Elador along with 5 more gold scrolls and a bunch of gems and gold coins. Then you'll be able to participate in beginner events to get another free epic hero named Soliana, a bunch of legendary equipment, and a platinum scroll, which will give you another free epic or legendary hero. Guys, wow. Just be sure to use the code within 3 hours of downloading the game and after completing the tutorial. And I will see you in Gemstone Legends. Alright, so I set this defense up during my live stream and I called it the Bumblebee defense, and that's because it's alternating yellow and purple. I'm going to talk about why I think that works in just a moment, but just to update you, this is a bloody battle tournament. We're using only 3 stars, all the colors are available. So I like this Bumblebee style when all the colors are available, because typically whenever a tournament's missing a color, that makes it so that you can just set up the tank as the strong color against, you know, whatever is missing. So, you know, basically, like, if red is missing, then you typically want to set up a green tank because, well, it's harder to take it out. But when that's not the case, then it's good to take color into account in what you're doing on defense to try and replicate color weakness just a little bit. Just to show you what my defense is doing here, currently it has an A. I do want you to recognize that my defense isn't loaded up with emblems. There's only one hero that has talents on him, and that's Kvasir. But I think Kvasir is really important to this defense as well. So you'll remember it's Bloody Battle, so healing and resurrection have no effect. One thing that I see over and over in the Bloody Battle tournaments is that people put healers in their defense anyway. And I do realize that some heroes do more than just healing, like they might increase attack or something like that. But still, you're not getting the full amount of, you know, quality out of a hero that you possibly could by putting a healer in when healing's not having an effect. Also, you know, remember, resurrection doesn't have an effect either, and there's a few heroes that do that. I think people forget about that. What I try to do with defense is, in Bloody Battle, just have really fast knifing heroes, basically, which is what you see going on here. With I've got Costume Balthazar, I've got Bjorn, and then two Costume Banes here. Now, I don't actually have it set on the costume at the moment because I like the regular side, but it still gets the bonus, so that's important. Now, one reason Kvasir is so strong, and, well, one reason why he's the only 3-star hero I have with emblems on it, is because, well, he's fast. I mean, that's nice, but what he does is basically fake healing by creating those B minions that inherit 15% HP and 17% attack from the caster. That's like fake healing. So, you know, you set Kvasir off a couple of times, and that more than makes up for any damage that's being done to your heroes. So that's really important in being able to keep your team alive. So, you know, while I see other people accidentally putting healers on their team, if you're putting a hero like Kvasir on, you're actually going to keep your team alive. So what's happening here is people are attacking my defense. They're setting Kvasir off once or twice. Not only do you get the benefit of sort of fake healing in that way, or at least your heroes are harder to kill, it's like an increase in both, like, longevity and healing. But those minions are actually doing a good bit of damage as well. So with that damage combined on top of the fact that these other heroes are basically just knifing at fast speed, that's why I think this defense is doing so well. Now, if you think about the color setup here, why I call it the Bumblebee setup, and why I think it's good whenever all the colors are active for a tournament, is because what are you going to do when you bring heroes here? Are you going to overload on purple because there's a yellow tank? You could do that and take out Kvasir, but then you're going to run into an issue with Bjorn and Balthazar here.
Now, even though there's two more Banes, which are also yellow, and the strong purple team would be good against that, it is going to have a problem getting through Bjorn and Balthazar. The tile damage is not going to be good enough to really do much, and that's protecting the Banes. But, you know, what if you bring heavy yellow to try and deal with the two purple flanks? Well, obviously that's a problem, because you're going to have difficulty taking out Kvasir and the two Banes on the side. So this defense creates a sort of conundrum whenever all the colors are available. That's why I like it, and that's why I'm running with it. I've done this a few times. I've even done it in war from time to time. But I don't know, what do you think about the Bumblebee defense here? Is this something that you've used before? What did you do for your tournament defense, and how's it doing in this tournament? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoy videos like this, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, hitting the bell notification so you know when I drop more videos or go live, and I will catch you in the next one.